have dominion over the world. 1 John chapter 5, verses 1 and 4. Whoever believes that Jesus is the Christ is born of God, and everyone who loves him who begot also loves him who is begotten of him. Verse 4, for whatever is born of God overcomes the world, and this is the victory that has overcome the world, our faith. The Apostle John writes there in 1 John 5, 1, that whoever believes that Jesus is the Christ is born of God. And then he says in verse 4 that whoever is born of God overcomes the world. To overcome simply means to have mastery over, to supersede, to dominate, to have authority over the world. Now, what is he talking about when he refers to the world? As you look at it in the writings of John and in other places, the world in the New Testament, of course, the Greek word cosmos, represents several things, but one of the key things that the cosmos represents in New Testament context, it represents the entire system of evil and rebellion against God. So whoever is born of God overcomes the world, the system of evil and rebellion. Anything that is operating on the earth, that is part of the world's system, which is evil and which is in rebellion against God, you overcome. That means as believers, as people who have been born of God, we don't have to be subject to, we don't have to be controlled and dominated by the system of evil and rebellion that we live in. We're in the system, we're here, but we don't have to be controlled by it and dominated by it. Now, what are some of the expressions of the system of evil and rebellion? Of course, there is sin, there is unrighteousness, there is injustice, there is unfairness, there is all kinds of expressions of this evil and rebellion that is part of the world system. Now, we are here on the earth, so we are in the system in one sense, but we're not part of the system because we have been called out of it. We belong to Jesus Christ. We are born again, and we're part of God's kingdom. And because we are born again and because we belong to God's kingdom, the Bible tells us that we overcome the system of evil and rebellion. So, as you go about your daily life, keep this in your heart and mind. You are born of God, and whoever is born of God overcomes the world. When you face something that is of evil and rebellion against God, but you are being attacked or you are being confronted with it, rise up with the spirit of a conqueror. Know that you can overcome the world. Know that you can overcome the evil and the rebellion that you're seeing around you. If it is injustice, if it is ungodliness, if it is unrighteousness, if it is whatever people are trying to do, you rise up and you dominate. You overpower it using the fact that you have your rating in life and your position of dominion at the right hand of God. You dominate that. Now, what if a believer does not exercise their authority? What if a believer doesn't exercise the dominion that is in him or her? Well, then they will just continue in life, remaining in subjection to the things that they actually have been given authority over. Demonic powers will continue to harass them and torment them. The world system will begin to overpower them, put them down and under. But really, as believers, we are supposed to overcome the world. We have authority over serpents and scorpions. So we must use our authority. We must rise up with the spirit of a conqueror, the spirit of dominion, and put these things under. God desires for that to happen. That's why he gave us dominion. Let's pray. Father, we ask in the name of Jesus that as we go through life and we see situations around us that are part of the world system of evil and rebellion, God, that we will arise up and we'll put it down, because your word says that whoever is born of God overcomes the world. And we know we can do this in Jesus' name. Help us to do it, we pray. Thank you, Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.